Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, we're going to look at E and Z isomers for alkenes. In the last video, we looked at cis and trans isomers, which if you haven't seen that yet, click the link below, or visit leiaforsci.com/cis-trans. And we left off with a question of what happens when you're trying to find cis or trans for a pi bond, where the substituents are set up in a way where they could be cis to each other, or they could be trans to each other. And when that's the case, you need a higher level of ranking, and this is where the E and Z configurations come in. You typically use E and Z when you have more than one carbon coming out of the same sp2 carbon atom. For example here, we have an sp2 carbon with both a methyl and an ethyl, so we can't rank based on just one. We also use it when we have non-carbon substituents like halogens, alcohols, or larger priority groups. For example, if you had to name a molecule that looked like this, we would have to find a way to imply that the chlorine is on the same side as the methyl, whereas the methyl on the left is opposite the methyl on the right. The first thing we have to do is rank the substituents coming off of that carbon atom using the Kahn-Ingold-Prelog system. This is something I teach in detail in the stereochemistry series, which you can find linked below, or visit leiaforsci.com/ranking. Don't skimp on this, it's very important. As a quick review, we're ranking based on atomic number. Now you'll typically have a periodic table on your quiz or exam, but this is where those 10 atoms that I had you memorize in the beginning of Orgo, this is another place where they really come in handy. So if you haven't memorized that yet, do so now. We have hydrogen, then carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Below that we have phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, and then bromine and iodine. These 10 atoms are the most common that you're going to see, especially in a topic like E and Z. As a reminder, iodine is your highest priority, then bromine, then chlorine, then sulfur, then phosphorus, then fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, and hydrogen is always your lowest. If there is a deuterium thrown in, remember that it outranks hydrogen because it's just a heavy isotope of hydrogen. If you're comfortable with ranking, let's move on. Let's try the chlorine example, and if you haven't memorized the atoms yet, we'll keep it on the side for you. Here's the method that I find to be simplest and least overwhelming. First, identify and highlight your pi bond. Make it very obvious which two carbons you're looking at, and then cover half of the molecule. This is so important because when you have a lot of substituents, it's very easy to get overwhelmed and it's very easy to forget what you're looking at. But if you cover it by putting your hand or a piece of paper or something over half of the molecule, you're only focusing on one sp2, one pi bound carbon at a time, and keeping it simple. Next, you want to identify the atoms that you're ranking specifically. In this case, we have a chlorine versus a carbon in that methyl group. And we see that chlorine outranks carbon. That makes chlorine priority number one and carbon priority number two. Finally, draw an arrow perpendicular to the pi bond in the direction of your higher priority. In this case, my pi bond goes in this direction, so I will draw an arrow facing up towards the chlorine. We have one side. Now we cover it so we're not distracted and do the same thing on the other side. Here's my sp2 carbon, but I only have one substituent. What am I ranking? Don't forget that in line structure, hydrogen atoms are invisible, but they're still there. We have a hydrogen atom on this carbon of the pi bond, and that means we're ultimately comparing carbon and hydrogen. Carbon will outrank hydrogen, making the methyl group priority number one and the hydrogen priority number two. Since the higher priority is facing up from the pi bond, we'll draw an arrow perpendicular to the pi bond facing priority number one, and then uncover both sides. Having the arrows allows you to avoid the groups. It allows you to avoid being overwhelmed, and all you have to do is identify. Are your arrows facing in the same direction as we have here, or do you have one arrow facing up and one down in opposite directions? Now be careful, don't call them cis or trans. This is not cis and trans. We're simply looking to see if the two higher priority groups are facing in the same or opposite direction. If you identify that your two arrows are facing in the same direction, this would be the Z configuration. And the way I remember that is by thinking that the two higher priority groups are located on Zizame Zide, all spelled with a Z. Zizame Zide tells me that it's the Z configuration. If the two high priority groups are located opposite each other, you get the E configuration. And the way I remember it is that these two groups are located opposite from each other. Opposite spelled with an E to remind me they are on opposite sides of each other. Let's go back to our example. In this case, we know that the chlorine and methyl, both higher priority, are facing Zizame Zide. That makes this the Z configuration. To name this molecule, we start with the basic naming rules, where we see a total of four carbons in the parent chain for a first name of butte, and a pi bond sitting in the middle of the molecule. I will number this molecule from the left, so that chlorine and the pi bond are both on number 2 rather than 3. Remember, we want the total lowest set of numbers, which gives me a last name of 2-ene, and then a chlorine substituent on carbon 2 for 2-chloro. And lastly, we want to include the EZ configuration. In this case, we have Z. To put the name together, we start with the Z at the start of the name and put it into parentheses, followed by the substituent, which is a chlorine on carbon 2. We drag the 2 in front of the butte, giving me 2-butene. The reason we put the Z in parentheses is to make sure that we don't confuse the letter Z with the number 2. Look at how I've drawn them. They kind of look similar, but having the Z in parentheses reminds us, no, this is not a designation of where something shows up. This is Z telling me about the stereochemistry or the geometry about that pi bond. For a final name of Z2-chloro-2-butene, let's go back and name our first example. We have a total of 6 bonds, giving me a first name of hex. We have an option to number it from the right or left. If I number it from the left, I hit the pi bond at 3 and the methyl group at 4. If I number from the right, I hit the pi bond and the methyl group at 3 for a total lower set of numbers, so we're going to choose the red numbering. With a pi bond starting at carbon 3, we have 3-ene. A methyl group at carbon 3 gives me 3-methyl, but now we have to specify what's going on with the pi bond. We don't use cis or trans because we have a methyl and an ethyl. Instead, we'll use the EZ system. We'll start with the group on the left, identifying the sp2 carbon, and recognizing because the substituent is invisible, there's a hydrogen atom. If you don't have them memorized yet, use this chart as a guide. We're comparing carbon to hydrogen. Carbon outranks hydrogen, making the ethyl group priority number 1 and the hydrogen priority number 2, or simply the higher priority in the up direction. Now cover the left side and look at the sp2 carbon on the right. Coming off of this carbon, we have a methyl and an ethyl. Methyl is a CH3, that's carbon. Ethyl is a CH2CH3, that's also carbon. This is where it really helps to understand priority ranking. As a reminder, we're dealing with methyl, which is CH3, and ethyl, which is CH2CH3. We look at the very first atom, which is carbon. Since it's the same, we rule it out and go to the next highest priority. The methyl group has 3 hydrogens, so any one hydrogen is the next high priority. The ethyl group has 2 hydrogens and 1 carbon, but carbon is the highest priority. So now we compare carbon to hydrogen. Carbon wins, making the ethyl group priority group number 1 and the methyl priority number 2. We'll draw an arrow in the direction of number 1 and then uncover the molecule. Looking at the two arrows, they are away from each other or opposite from each other, telling me that this molecule is in the E configuration. Let's put the name together, starting with E in parentheses, followed by the substituent 3-methyl. Pull the 3 in front of hex, giving me 3-hexene, for a final name of E 3-methyl 3-hexene. Your professor may choose to leave the 3 where it is. In that case, the name would be E3-methylhex3-ene. Both are correct. What about a molecule that looks like this? We have a pi bond with 2 unique substituents. If we look at the sp2 carbon on the left, chlorine outranks ethyl, making the chlorine higher priority. But on the right, we don't appear to have anything, meaning we have 2 hidden hydrogen atoms. But once again, like we saw in the last video, hydrogen is the same as hydrogen. If you have 2 equal priority groups, one doesn't outrank the other, and that means there is no stereoisomerism here, because there's no way to differentiate the top or the bottom. So this is not going to be cis or trans, and it's also not going to be E or Z because of that hydrogen. The trick to remember, terminal alkenes without anything fancy on the end are not cis-trans and not EZ. For even more examples on cis-trans and EZ, click the link below or visit my website, leahforsci.com/cis-trans.
Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for resources and information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, then I have a deal for you, a free copy of my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry. Use the link below or visit orgosecrets.com to grab your free copy. After downloading your free copy of my ebook, you'll begin receiving my exclusive email updates with cheat sheets, reaction guides, study tips, and so much more. You'll also be the first to know when I have a new video or live review coming up. If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up and share it with your organic chemistry friends and classmates. I will be uploading many videos over the course of the semester, so if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, do so right now to be sure that you don't miss out.